Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews once again. I'm excited. I've already tried this one. Now, we've got a lager. We've got a cold lager. It's cold. Look, it's chilly, chilly, willy. Oh, it's got air on it. Get off. It's chilly, chilly, willy, man. Look, it's chilly. A very unusual thing because it's one of the last places I would expect. Oh, come on, voice. It's all strained like that. One of the last places I would expect to see a lager being produced from, because they are a quintessentially English kind of a English brewery, you know, and they brew a lot of quintessentially English beers. And we've got a new English lager. Now, what can I say? I've already tried it, and before this, my favourite, all-time favourite lager of all time was Gold Lager from Nils Oskar, from good old Sweden, and not far behind that, I think it was Schiehallion, from Williams Brothers. He's pretty damn good. Brooklyn is another one, all the way in America. Brooklyn Lager. Yeah, you got Brewdog 66, is it? Or 77? 70, no, 60, I don't know. Something like that. 77 or 66, one or the other. That's another lovely one. But Gold Lager was kind of head and shoulders above them. I tried this one. Warm. It was like warm, still in the case. I got back home from being on the train and everything, and I had a few of these in the bag. You know, down at the JBBF. And it's the same amount of journey from one side of London to the other. It takes as long as going, someone else was, where was they, right in the middle of England somewhere. I can't remember where they said exactly, but it took them about the same amount of time as it took me. But there you go. I do diverge. Sorry, I do digress. I'm gagging for this one. This is, show you it once again in case you didn't get it first time. This is Hogsback Brewery. Hogsback Brewery. Hogstar. New English Lager. 4.5 on the Richter scale. This is kind of a trial run. So I've got this a little bit early. I think they're releasing it in something like 6 weeks or something like that. So you'll be getting it around then. This is our first trial brew of a style of beer. Which we call New English Lager. The refreshment of old style. Let me get my glass out. I should have glasses, really, shouldn't I? A refreshment of old style lagers, but with greater depth of flavour and aroma, in keeping with the English ale tradition. We use special lager malts and 5 different hops added at different stages of the boil. I'm getting all moist already. Together with a small quantity of natural herb extracts. Cool, wow. We then ferment with a special yeast and mature it for at least 5 weeks, during which the flavour deepens and carbonation really develops. We do not pasteurise. Hogstar should always be drunk fresh and chilled. Please let us know what you think via our website, Facebook or Twitter. Watch out for trial brew number 2 coming soon. I hope yours truly gets one name as well. I think this is perfect as it is. I don't want to see any other lagers in my life ever. That is a glorious one, that really is. Right, let's go for that. One of my favourite beers of all time at the moment. Let's go. Let's see how we go. Beautiful crown on the top. Really like that. Let's show you the nice little crown. Isn't it lovely, look? Isn't it lovely? I like that. Oh, pretty. Printish. Let's go. All right. Lovely, glorious, beautiful, nutritious, delicious, fantastic. Right. Let's see what we got there. I've poured the lot in. We've got a nice little head, nice lily white head, nice little lacy head. Beautiful golden coloured beer. Golden coloured beer. Isn't that lovely? Let's give it a swirl and a smell. Really lovely little smells in there. Such glorious, lovely little smells. Gentle little biscuity notes. Everything's so pure smelling. It's just, it smells just spring watery, pure and lovely. No messing about here, I'm telling you. Just see if I can just twirl it gently again. Oh, little quiet hops, little lovely quiet hops. Not overtaking it, but still a little bit of zest in there. Still a little bit of something just to perk it up a little bit. Kind of like you've got biscuits with little tiny little bits of fruit in with it. You know, that sort of thing. Little gentle caramel background notes, but really gentle. Really, everything's just lovely. It's going to be refreshing. I know it is. It's going to be lovely. I'm so gagging for it. Right, cheers everyone. Bottoms up. Cheers. Oh, that is lovely. That is lovely. Oh, that is nice. There is a strange little note in there that I can't put my finger on. Almost kind of a very, very distant ginger almost. But that is, oh, so lovely. You can hardly taste like these herbs or whatever they're talking about. You know, possibly something like coriander as well, something. But you can't really taste them like as, you know, kind of being vigorous on you. You've got a lovely little bitter in hop there. Possibly something like a halotel or something like that. Just a little bit of pepperiness to it. But it's glorious. It's so lovely. It's not too bitter. It's not sweet. It's kind of nice. It's balanced. That is a perfect, perfect lager. That is fantastic. That really is glorious. One of my favourite beers of all time, that one. That is lovely. Right, what can I say about that? Get yourself down there, get yourself one of these, get yourself down to the brewery, I was going to say. Get yourself, like, down to whatever brewery, the shop, get yourself online, have a little chat with them, have a little chat on Facebook and Twitter. Order these before they're even released. Order them up, say, I want one. I've seen Terry drinking one, I want one. Pardon me, you will be glad you've got one. You really will. That is lovely. That is the best lager I've ever had. Right, enough said. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up, chin chin, Nostrovio and everything else. Cheers. Oh, that is good. See you in the next one. Don't be late. With me.